When controlling the risks of exposure to respirable crystalline silica, it's important to follow the hierarchy of control. If elimination and substitution are not possible, then engineering controls should be used. The two most common forms of engineering controls are on-tool dust suppression and on-tool dust extraction. Today we're talking about on-tool dust extraction systems. These remove dust at the source when working with crystalline silica materials. An on-tool dust extraction system is made up of a power tool, an on-tool attachment, and a hazardous dust class vacuum. Shadow vacuuming is not an engineering control or a form of on-tool dust extraction. The attachment is what connects the power tool to the vacuum. To work best, it needs to be as close as possible to the source of the dust. Attachments are tool and task specific. This means there are specific types of attachments designed for drilling, grinding, or cutting materials containing crystalline silica. Attachments that capture sawdust may not be effective at capturing respirable crystalline silica dust. It's important to ensure the on-tool attachment securely connects to the tool and the hose fitting. All connections should be fitted as the manufacturer recommends. Different hoses are available, and anti-static hoses are a good way to prevent a buildup of static electricity. Hazardous dust class vacuums are fitted with a filtration system designed to extract and contain hazardous dust. These vacuums come in three classes: low, medium, and high. When working with crystalline silica, the vacuum needs to be at least an M or an H class. To easily tell if a vacuum is one of these classes, look for this sticker on the side. If a vacuum isn't classed as an M or an H class, it's not suitable, even if it's marked as having a HEPA filter. It's important to choose the right vacuum for the job. Some things to consider are the tasks it will be used for, its compatibility with power tools and attachments, whether it's battery powered or corded, the weight and capacity, and if it needs to be a wet and dry vac. As you plan for your job, if you have any questions about the equipment, speak to the manufacturer. Waste management can be a source of re-exposure, so disposable bags inside the vacuum can be used to capture dust for easier and safer removal. You should always replace or clean the filters as the manufacturer recommends, avoid using compressed air, and dispose of offcuts appropriately. For more information, please visit the WorkSafe website.